Station. This is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
This is the International Space Station. I hear you loud and clear, and welcome.
Hi, my name is Beatrice. I'm in seventh grade and part of the Calculus Project. I would like to know, how do you move in microgravity?
That's a good question. I can try and give you a quick demonstration here, but the nice thing up here is that you're not walking and you just push, and Newton's laws apply. But you don't have all the resistance and stuff that you have down on the Earth. And so if I just put a small little force, I'm just going to drift in the direction that I put that force in. So if I pick my feet up here off this handrail and I just push myself towards Samantha, I'll just start drifting ever so slowly. And then she can stop me with a finger, and of course, then I start rotating and that kind of thing. But you can see how easy it is to move me around. So it's really nice. We just had a cargo vehicle, a SpaceX Dragon cargo vehicle, show up, and it had 5,800 pounds of supplies, 5,800 pounds. But up here, they have mass, but they're weightless. And so we're able to pull all that stuff out and just start floating it from one end of the space station to the other. And so I am super, super thankful that we are in microgravity up here, because moving that 5,800 pounds of cargo around without that would be a real challenge and a real workout.
Hi, my name is Ibrahim. I am a seventh grader at Alexander Twilight Academy. I would like to know, do you get taller in space?
Hey, Ibrahim. Actually, as a matter of fact, you do. You know, your spine, where you are on the ground, it kind of gets compressed, right? Your spine is made of vertebra, and then in between there's like discs that are like softer material, a softer tissue. And when you're on the ground, your weight compresses your spine. And so up here in space, because we're weightless, that doesn't happen. And so those discs can kind of expand, and our spine stretches out, and we become a little bit taller. However, when we get back to Earth, all that reverts back to normal, and we get back to our normal height.
Hi, my name is Corey. I'm an eighth grader from Alexander Twilight Academy. My question is, how do you drink liquid since it floats?
Hey, thanks, Corey. That's a great question, and it is actually one of the cooler things we get to do. So for an example, most of our drinks come in little bags like this, but sometimes, so you can drink them out of a straw, but you can get a little more fun with it too. And Samantha's going to help me out here. It can also turn into a disaster really quick, so so we're ready to go. Here you go. So you squeeze the water out, and you get these little bubbles of water. So you can get small ones like that, or you can end up with a bigger bubble.
Nice.
There you go.
Good job.
Which is more water than it looks like, so it's always an entertaining thing to try and manage something like this.
Good job.